month had online coaching classes. Friends, we shall discuss the main topic of GS is history, and I hope that you will understand this topic very easily. So let's start. First of all, I would like to ask you what is history and what is the definition of history. Historian, clear? So friends, what is history? First of all, what is history? My question is that what is history? History means, according to Hegel, Hegel said that history repeats itself. Hegel said that history repeats itself, and after that Karl Marx extended this definition and said that history repeats itself first as tragedy and second as farce. After that, according to E.H. Carr said that history is an unending dialogue between present and past. So students, according to Hegel, according to Karl Marx, according to E.H. Carr, and the normally definition is that the study of past is called history. Normally definition, clear students? So first of all, I told about history, what is history according to Hegel, Karl Marx, E.H. Carr, and the normal definition is that the study of past is called history. And history, clear, means origin of history. Second question is that origin of history. History words, the English word history is derived from the Greek word historia. The stories means investigation, search, research, inquiry, etc. Thus the knowledge acquired by investigation is called historia. Clear friends? So origin of history, the English word history is derived from the Greek word historia, which means investigation, search, research, inquiry, etc. Thus the knowledge acquired by investigation is called historia. After that, the Greek historian Herodotus, he was the real historian, and he wrote only one book, Historica, which defines the invasion of 500 BC. Clear students? And Caesar was the first person who gave this title, the father of history is called Herodotus. Clear friends.
And after that, the father of modern history.
The father of modern history. The father of modern history is that Leopold von Ranke. Clear students? And after that, I want to clear some time glossaries which are related to time. So students, BC, AD, decade, and century, and then millennium. BC is the acronym of before Christ, and in short we said that BC. AD is the acronym of Anno Domini, and in short AD. Decade, the period of 10 years equal to decade, and the period of 100 years is called century, and then the period of 1000 years is called millennium. After that, we shall discuss BC and AD. Before Christ means Isa Masih. Before the birth of Isa Masih. So the years before the birth of Isa Masih is known as BC. In short, and in the birth of Isa Masih is known as AD, in short, Anno Domini. Clear students? For example, BC 5-6-300 BC is known as this date Gautam Buddha was born in 563 BC and died in 483 BC So students, clear? Any problem? Do you have any problem? Let's start. Clear? So, and Anno Domini? ठीक है, क्लियर, ओके. जीसस क्रस्ट वाज क्रसीफाइड इन 30 एडी. क्लियर, एडी 30 एडी. एंड देन स्टार्ट्स division of history. First of all, bipartite division. Bi means two, partite means part. Divide into two part. And second, tripartite division. Tri means three, partite means part. Clear students? Bipartite division means three strict and strict period. Pre-strict and strict period. And tripartite division is that pre-strict, proto-strict, and last strict period. Clear friends? Pre-strict means history is generally divided into two parts, two periods, pre-strict and strict. The pre-strict period is that there has no written evidences. It's called pre-strict period. Start? Okay, clear? Now next. Clear students? And the period that have written evidence is called strict period. In other words, the period before the beginning of writing is called pre-strict period, and the period after the beginning of writing is known as strict period. Clear students? The टाइम पीरियड ऑफ प्री हिस्ट्रिक इज एक्सेप्टेड एट जो 30 लाख बीसी टू 600 बीसी एंड द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ हिस्ट्रिक पीरियड एज 600 बीसी टू टिल डेट. Clear students? And tripartite division of history is more prevalent in practice. According to this, history is divided into three parts: prehistoric, protohistoric, and historic period. Students, clear students? And Christoph Salerius. Christoph Salerius divided the history into three parts: ancient history, and second medieval, and modern. And according to sources, history is divided into three parts. According to sources, archaeological sources, first of all, archaeological sources. Second, literary sources, and third, foreign sources. Clear students? Foreign sources. So archaeological sources include coins, inscriptions, poetry, sculpture, etc. ठीक है students, okay students, and after that the next day we are going to start what is coins, what is inscriptions, what is poetry, what is sculpture. Clear students, and bye students. See you tomorrow. Bye. Jai Hind.